Okay, we're gonna see how to get the ratio of the sides of a 30, 60, 90 special right triangle. And to do that, we are going to begin with an equilateral triangle. And that means we have a triangle like this, where all the sides are going to be the same and all the angles inside are the same as well. And this is my equilateral triangle right here. I want to make this side to be 2 units long, so that this will also be 2 units and this will also be 2 units. Okay, and this 2 right here, we just picked it, and it's just that our number later on will be nicer for the sides. You'll see. Anyways, let's continue. Let's figure out the angles. We know that the sum of all the angles in any triangle has to be 180 degrees, right? And because these three angles are the same, so we just do 180 divided by 3. We will get 60 each for this one right here, right? So this angle will be 60 degrees. And this angle will also be 60 degrees. Likewise, this one will also be 60 degrees. They add up to 180. And now I'm going to take a look of this triangle, and then we'll cut this into half from the middle right here, straight down. So that you see, this is straight down, and we will form a 90 degree angle here. And now let's look at the left half right here. And this is the 30, 60, 90 triangle. So we see that. Let me just redraw the triangle here for you guys. We have this angle, that's the 90 degree, and then this is still 60, right? 60 degrees here. Originally, this is 60 degrees, but then we cut into half and half, so that means this little angle here will be only 30 degrees. And now let's take a look. This side here is now the hypotenuse of this right triangle, and it's still 2, right? And you see now, this is the reason why I picked 2. Because if you look at the base of the original triangle right here, I was using 2, right? But then we cut this into half and half. So that means this part right here has to be 1. This red one right here is 1. So that means this is 1 as well. And at the end, we just have to figure out how long is this side here. Okay, just do the usual business. We are going to use the Pythagorean theorem. Let me just say this side here is A. This unknown side, I don't know. Let me just put down B. And the hypotenuse right here is C. And we know that A squared plus B squared will be C squared. And let's just get to work. A is 1, so we have 1 squared. Plus B, we don't know, right? So that's still B squared. And this is equal to C is 2. So we have 2 squared. Let's work this out. 1 squared is 1 plus b squared, we don't know, so just leave it as how it is. And this is equal to 2 squared. That means 2 times 2, we have 4. And then we can just subtract 1 on both sides. That will cancel. And then we see that we will end up with b squared is equal to 4 minus 1, which is 3. At the end, we once again take the positive square root, so that the square and the square root will cancel. We get B is equal to square root of 3. And that's the side right here. B is square root of 3. Now, as we can see, whenever we have a 30, 60, 90 special right triangle, the ratio of the sides are 1, square root of 3, and 2. Make sure you remember that the one right here, the shortest side, is the opposite toward the 30 degree angle, and then the square root of 3 is the opposite of the 60 degree angle, and then the 2 is the hypotenuse. That's it.